Good evening, everybody, and welcome live here to Racing Hotspot Weekend Roundup. It is July 17th, 2016. I am your host this evening, Mr. Devin Poslusny. This will also act as the post-race show here at New Hampshire Motor Speedway. So to go over what we have coming for you in the show lineup here, we're going to talk about Motorsports in 60, which recaps the Auto Lotto 200 at New Hampshire Motor Speedway. Then we'll talk about IndyCar in Toronto. Then we'll go over what the weekend consisted of here at NHMS, as well as talking about all the top fives from the other series that we're running here. Then we're going to go to a commercial after that and come back and talk about the points championship and NASCAR, of course, and talking about the New Hampshire 301 live here from New Hampshire Motor Speedway. After that, I'm unsure of what's happening next week for racing, so I'm going to have to say we won't have a final lap tonight, but that's just because we just got out of the track about 10 minutes ago, maybe more like 20 minutes ago, but whatever. Anyways, here we go. Motorsports in 60. 60 seconds starts now. We'll talk about the Auto Lotto 200 starting now. So the Auto Lotto 200 was the NASCAR Xfinity Series race here at New Hampshire Motor Speedway yesterday. Here's the top five from the race. You had Austin Dillon finished fifth, Daniel Suarez finished fourth, Brad Keselowski finished third, Eric Jones finished second, and Kyle Busch, in dominating fashion, won the race here at NHMS. There was a long period of green flag laps, but also it was eventful as well. Ty Dillon got put into the wall along the back straightaway. There was a wad-up on the exit of Turn 2. There was a wad-up in Turn 2, and Ryan Priest blew a tire, causing an accident in the final laps of the race. That brings me to 22 seconds. So next, we're going to talk about the Honda Indy Toronto Grand Prix. I'm not sure if the race is over at this time or if it's still running, but it says lap 85 of 85, so I'm assuming the race is over. Yep, it's over. Okay, here we go. Here's the top five from IndyCar. I know a lot of NASCAR fans walking by don't really care about IndyCar, but that's just me. That's just what we have to cover. Takuma Sato finished fifth. Tony Kanaan finished fourth. James Hinchcliffe finished third. Helio Castroneves finished second, and Will Power won in Toronto. So now, we're going to come back to NHMS. Let's look at what happened in the weekend so far. The All-Star Shootout for the NASCAR Wheeler Modified Tour on Friday afternoon was very eventful, the last lap, of course, being the most chaotic. Here's the top five. Doug Colby finished fifth. Ryan Priest finished fourth. Ron Silk finished third. Eric Goodale finished second. And Bobby Santos, on a last lap pass, won the race. The Modified Tour then ran on Saturday in the New England 100. Here's the top five. Finishing fifth was Ryan Newman. Ron Silk finished fourth. Patrick Emmerling finished third. Donnie Leah finished second. And Doug Colby won the race, beating Leah by probably about a foot to the line, of course. And then the Granite State 70 was run yesterday on Saturday. Here's the top five. Austin Tarrant finished fifth. Kyle Benjamin finished fourth. Justin Haley finished third. Todd Gilliland finished second. And Corey LaJoy got the win overall. Now, the driver involved in the accident, number 30 car, I believe it's Dominique Van Wingen, was the driver in the number 30 car who was taken out of the car via the jaws of life, unfortunately. At this time, as I said on race day, we still have no updates on her condition. But as soon as we find anything out, we will put it up on Facebook, our social media sites. So we will keep you in the loop. So now, we're going to quickly take a break here. We'll come back, talk about the NASCAR race here. We'll give you the full field rundown. And then also we're going to talk about the points championship. So don't go anywhere on the other side of the break. We'll talk about all those things. Be right back, guys. Welcome back live here to Racing Hotspot Weekend Roundup. Once again, I am your host, Mr. Devin Poslusny. Now we're moving on to NASCAR here, and they just finished the race probably about an hour ago, the New Hampshire 301. Let's go through the recap before we get to the top five. I actually took notes. Dave would be so proud. Right off the bat, Jimmy Johnson was on the pole, of course. And on lap two, Kyle Busch takes the lead from Johnson. On lap 35, we had the competition caution because it downpoured here in New Hampshire last night. On lap 62, Michael McDowell obviously having issues. He was slow on the racetrack around the bottom of the on the apron. No caution came out for that. On lap 88, Martin Truex Jr. claimed the lead from Kyle Busch. Then, soon after, on lap 100, the number 34, I believe it was David Reagan, went spinning down the back straightaway. I believe he got the air taken off of him, and he went around. On lap 171, Kyle Busch retakes the lead, and Truex was not giving up without a fight. That was for sure. On lap 181, we had green flag pit stops. And then on lap 219, a debris caution came out. On lap 257, Matt Kenseth took the lead from Martin Truex Jr. for the first time in the afternoon. And then another debris caution came out a couple laps later on 264. On the restart on 267, Denny Hamlin took the lead from Matt Kenseth. But then right on lap 270, Matt Kenseth took the lead right on back. On that restart, Alex Bowman and Chase Elliott had made contact with other drivers, causing tire rubs. On lap 274, both Bowman and Elliott wrecked in turn 1 and 2 with tire issues, obviously the blown tires. Then on the restart of 276, once again the same thing happened, but to Kurt Busch. And just a couple laps later on 281, Kurt Busch blew a tire going into turn 3, bringing out another caution. On lap 285, the last caution of the day came out. Kyle Larson got shuffled up on the back straightaway and went sliding through the turn 3 grass. And that would lead up to a 10-lap shootout, which at that point, Matt Kenseth, leading at the time, was able to get away and run away with the race. And now let's go over the top five. Finishing fifth was Greg Biffle. Kevin Harvick finished fourth. Joey Logano finished third. Tony Stewart, with a couple laps left, was able to get the lead away from get second place from Joey Logano. And Matt Kenseth then went on to win the race. Now, we do have, quickly here with Racing Hotspot, some breaking news about the possible 88 ride for next week at Indianapolis, and I'll give it over to my bud Mark. What's going on, Mark?
I'm really looking forward to Jeff Gordon driving the car at Indianapolis because he's won there before. I think it'd be pretty cool, and it was a good race. I mean, it could have been a lot better. Maybe Kevin Harvick could have won if he didn't just only have fourth gear, but it's always a pleasure, and I'll come and see you later, and thanks for my guest spot.
No problem at all. So,
woo!
So, to recap what he just said, Jeff Gordon, if the 88, or it looks like the 88 is going to be, Earnhardt's going to be out of the car once again at Indy. Okay, Mark just said, from what he hears, it was confirmed, Jeff Gordon will be in the 88 car next week at Indianapolis because Dale Earnhardt Jr. is still out with concussion-like symptoms. So, he's a Jeff Gordon fan. That's why he wanted to say that. Anyways, so there you go. Jeff Gordon is going to be in the ride next weekend at Indianapolis. So, now to the points championship. Wrap up the show here from New Hampshire Motor Speedway and to wrap up the weekend. But the points championship first. After Loudon, nobody moved. Nobody at all. Dave is still in first, Justin's still in second, I am still in third, Mark is still in fourth, and Kristen is still in fifth. Mark, by the way, is not that Mark, a different Mark, but they're still the same way we went into Loudon. the way we went out. I believe this is after Loudon. Let me just double check that. Make sure I didn't just jump the gun. I believe this is official, but if it is wrong, then I'll let you guys know. But yeah, so that's going to do it for this weekend roundup. Unfortunately, Dave was not able to make it today, so that's why the show is rather quick. But thank you for joining us this weekend and today for the show. Also, to all the fans out there around us, thank you for putting up with us taking over this section of the campground. We really do appreciate it. Yeah, all in all, it was a really good weekend. I'm glad that we have this type of setup now because we're out of the sun. Thank God. We also have the lighting system now in here. This way we can do later shows, which I hope we'll do again in September because, as you know, it gets dark really early in September. But, yeah, so thank you for joining us this weekend. Thank you for following along with all the videos from the Hall of Parade to the Friday show to the Saturday show, Sunday morning pre-race, and then Sunday evening post-race. Until we see each other for next week's show, recapping NASCAR in Indianapolis and other events that I'm unsure of right now, but make sure to check us out on Facebook for all those events coming up. But until we see each other for next week's show, recapping all that, have a good week, everybody. And thank you again for joining us here at New Hampshire Motor Speedway for July Race Week 2016. We will see you in September. Goodbye, everybody.